Mr. Lim Boon Heng, patron and advisor to the Centennial Celebrations Committee, Mr. Chua Che Jun, chairperson of the School Management Committee, Brother Dominic Yeo, supervisor of schools of the Montfort Brothers of St. Gabriel, principals Mark Minjut and Wilbur Wong, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to join you for the 100th anniversary celebration of Montfort Schools. I'm not a Montfortian, but I come from a brother school too. Not St. Patrick, unlike your MC. Not St. Joseph's, with which you have a friendly history. But Catholic High School. But you got to 100 first, so I'm here first. You've come a very long way, starting off as Holy Innocents, as Boon Heng has described, providing education to the farmers and fishermen living in the area, their children. And the school pioneers, undaunted, went house to house, encouraging the parents to encourage their children in school. And then in 1959, it became renamed Montfort School, when the Brothers of St. Gabriel took over. I should say I didn't know this bit of the history. I knew about the Holy Innocent Schools, the Chinese ones. But after preparing the speech for tonight, I discovered that there's a new, or there was another innocent school in Singapore. So I could say that I came to another brother's school and I discovered more innocence. And happy to be here and sharing it with you. By the 1960s, Montfort was sought after and had established its name for itself. Was sought after in Aokang and Serangoon for quality education. And it was also offering pre-university classes to students from other schools in the neighborhood. Then it split in 1974 into Montfort Junior and Montfort Secondary, with their pre-U classes combining with CJC, Catholic Junior College. So today you have about 2,000 students combined with upgraded premises and facilities, which are a vast improvement from the early days. Through the years, the principals and the teachers have put the schools onto a strong footing and given your students a very good education. For example, the late Mr. Teo Ka Ling, who was a student of Holy Innocents English School, who came back to serve his alma mater in various capacities for almost 40 years. He was a GP and an arts teacher, as well as a principal of the primary section. He had students who preferred to teach Teochew, or speak Teochew. And they didn't pay attention when he taught them English. But after they graduated and they found that they needed to improve their English for work, they came back and looked for him, and he continued to coach them and help them to do better. He also wrote the lyrics of the school anthem, The Song of the Brave. Educators like Mr. Teo played a vital role molding Montfortians, and in other schools all over Singapore, people like him molded us into the Singaporeans we are today. So it's a very good thing that you've all come back together for this anniversary, not just to catch up with old classmates, but also to celebrate the occasion with your principals and your teachers, and to express gratitude for the education you received, and at the same time, to raise some funds for Montfort. So I'd like to thank all the principals and teachers for your dedication and your hard work. Many Montfort alumni have gone on to be leaders, to be a man for others, true to your vision, serving Singapore in different roles. You've produced two ministers so far, Mr. Lim Boon Heng and Dr. Lee Boon Yang. You've produced two other members of parliament, Mr. Ng Ka Ting and Dr. Augustine Tan. Ka Ting is here this evening. And outside of politics, many Montfortians have done very well in your chosen fields, like Kwek Tong Boon, Chief Defence Scientist of Ministry of Defence. I didn't know it, but my draft says he's now Professor Kwek Tong Boon. So congratulations, Tong Boon. He was involved, he does many things which I can't tell you about tonight. But one thing I can tell you about is he was involved in Singapore's first commercial Earth observation satellite that was launched into space last year and is working well in outer space. Mr. Derek Wong, the national badminton player, who won a silver in the men's single at the last Commonwealth Games, and actively conducts clinics to impart his experience and skills to the juniors. And there are many others too. More than a dozen alumni have joined the priesthood, including the Archbishop of Singapore, William Goh. He's not here this evening, but he flies a school flag high. So I hope that the alumni will continue to be role models and will inspire the next generation of students. But even as we celebrate the past and the achievements of Montfortians, we must look ahead and prepare our children and our students for the future. Continue to give them a good academic education to build a strong foundation in literacy, numeracy, science, and humanities, but also emphasize their holistic development, to develop their talents, to give them the skills and the values that they will need for life, that will make them upright citizens, upright members of our society. To build a character and inculcate in them the right values so that they have a sense of belonging to Singapore, so that they want to help fellow Singaporeans, contribute back to society, and of course to the school. The school should also provide the students with a broad range of experiences and encourage their interest in non-academic areas. You have a strong tradition in sports and outdoor adventure. I saw some of the pictures just now outside in the exhibition, Outward Bound School, your overseas activities, community work in neighboring countries. And I see that the young students nowadays have many more opportunities to do these things. For example, I'm told just last month, the Sec 3 cohort did a land and sea expedition, trekking, cycling, and kayaking, 50 kilometers in Singapore, demonstrating teamwork and resilience, and building memories which I'm sure they'll recall fondly over a lifetime. So I'm glad that Montfort has focused on values-driven education and character development. You've partnered the Children's Cancer Foundation in the Hair for Hope event last year. And this Montfort School, apart from being a school and teaching students, has also become a shaving site. A site for students and also other members of the public to shave their hair to raise funds for the Children Cancer Foundation. I don't see anybody who has recently participated tonight, but I'm sure the next occasion will soon come. And it's not the students, but the students, I'm told, cajole their family members into participating, and the last time you did this, you raised $40,000. It's a project which not only raises funds, but helps the students to empathize with young cancer patients and to build compassion. Montfort students, given this grooming and this nurturing, demonstrate exemplary behavior and leadership even from a young age. And I expected to do so. Like Princeton Toh, who's in primary 5 now, I met him just now. He excels academically, he's also a prefect, and recently led his peers in a project called Friends of Singa to show more appreciation to the non-teaching staff, the administrators, the cleaners, the canteen vendors. And he encourages his peers to write appreciation notes, to make them into posters, and to present to the staff, which I think is a very good project. And I should like, go ahead, applaud him. I should digress just to tell you a story which I picked up recently, told by somebody who wrote about how he went to business school and he studied all the techniques of analysis and description and how to read the accounts and how to make business plans and mergers, acquisitions, takeovers, and so on. and prepared for his final exam. And he went into his final exam, and there was one blank piece of paper set, which was the exam paper. And the instructor says, well, there's only one question, which is very simple. Please write down on this piece of paper the name of the janitor who cleans this room every day. And the person who wrote this essay said, well, he failed that exam. He didn't know who the name was. And so the instructor said, there you are. I mean, you can learn all these techniques, but it's the people who work for you who count, and right down to the lowest at the bottom of the organization, you have to know them, care for them, and that's what will make you a success. And I think so therefore, I think that Princeton and the Friends of Singha are on the right track. Tonight's theme is celebrating the past, charting the future. It's an apt theme. You can be proud of your achievements over the last century. You join a very small group, although gradually growing, of centenary schools in Singapore. And the vibrance and vigor of Montfort attests to the strong support by the community of the school and the good education it has given to generations of students. So I congratulate the management, principals, teachers, staff, parents, alumni, and students. And it's not put down here, but I should thank Boon Heng for inviting me and sharing the day with me, with you all. So may you continue your good work, nurture many more gentlemen, scholars, sportsmen, and leaders for many more years to come. Thank you very much.